that you no, want to use?
I can't really hold them. Shaky hand.
Shaky hand, okay. All right. Let's go. And she starts using the blade like a walking stick. And you're kind of like a few feet back watching her.
Doesn't seem safe.
Go forward.
Hey, people get out of the way, though.
Yeah, they that's really true. Do.
Found a chicken. It's gone now.
Anybody want a pig?
I prophesized dinner.
So
that's right.
You're walking through the streets, and you're walking past a Leaf's place. Now, Leaf is this young boy. He's probably, I want to say, 19 at most, and he really wants to be a Viking. He really wants to go out, but he is not the greatest at sword play, and so you see him back there, and he's practicing with your arch nemesis, who's kind of hanging all over him. And you have been trying to catch his eye, which should be easy for someone that is basically a boulder, because you are a strong Viking person. Mm-hmm. You should definitely be the one he's interested in, right? Mm-hmm. And so they're doing this whole thing, and she catches her eye. You guys catch each other's eye. He's not paying attention. And she kind of just gives you this really shitty smile, and then kind of goes back. Do you just leave? Do you just walk away, or do you?
No, I'd probably go over there.
Okay. Oh, how you doing? Oh, he stops.
I'm
swinging the sword.
Busy. Lots of preparation for the coming battle. I noticed that you were practicing.
Well, yeah, I want to be ready. I want to make sure that I can hold my own.
Her name is Gora?
Gora, yeah. I believe so. Let me double check. Yeah.
Yeah, canon. It's Gora.
Gora. So it's G-R-O-A. So it's...
G-R-O-A.
Gra?
Gra.
Gra.
I don't know how to pronounce those names.
Yeah, that one's hard.
Gra.
I looked up the pronunciation of my name when I did. I'll have to look that one up.
How do you pronounce your name properly?
Birna.
Okay.
Birna.
Oh, beer nuts. Go ahead.
Right?
Yeah.
Birna.
Never going to get
there.
Birna.
It's super easy.
Bob. Anyway.
Mark. I'm going to call you Mark.
Mark. Yeah.
Mark. Everyone is Mark. Pronounce Shonk.
Markina, because you're a woman. Anyway, go ahead.
Markina. Oh, yes. That's way easier.
The classically feminine version of Mark.
Everyone knows it. Everyone's kids named that. Yes. I think I might be able to help you with your thrust. I know that you've been
really.
I know that you've been,
whoa.
You've been working with
the joke's right Gora
here.
Dear heavens.
But I think this might be easier. So I want to kind of go around behind him if you don't mind help
and just, like adjust his hips.
She she's like backs off as you kind of like jostle in there and.
Oh no, Gora, you don't have to leave. Actually, why don't you stand across from Leaf here? And that way you can be his opponent.
Okay.
And so I just want to kind of help him basically. Here's my goal. You can tell me how I'm going to do this.
But
my
goal is how murder happens in Viking world. Go ahead.
I want to basically get her off guard. But
do you want to get her off?
Guard.
Okay.
with his thrust. All right. We're all on the same page. All right. Go ahead.
Okay, I see what's happening.
Do I need to roll for that at all, or can
absolutely. You're using a real weapon, so why not?
Well, you're using someone's arm with a real weapon
right?
in it,
exactly.
right?
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
So she's like puppeting
his
body.
Hand and yeah, doing
I'm
this.
Helping.
I would say, I'd say do a dex roll. And what you're trying to do is just knock her off to the side or
not
whatever?
Not necessarily. It's just basically I'm a better fighter than she is. Mm-hmm. So the technique I'm showing him should. I want her to kind of not be expecting it. That's okay. My goal. Whether or not it works that way.
The only way that this can go horribly wrong is if you critically fail.
Or push.
Right. Those two things. So it's your dex.
So my dex, mm-hmm. as opposed to sword?
Do sword, sorry.
Sword. No, that's okay.
Oh.
Whoa!
What did you roll?
89. My sword is 75.
Push.
I'm going to push.
Do it.
Because this is the best time
this
to push.
This is important.
Oh, dear.
It's
Evan.
So important.
We'll never
Leaf,
need
let
those.
Me show you how to do this. Damn it!
It's oh, my
78.
Gosh. Oh, God, you killed Leaf.
Okay.
Severs his spine.
Let me show you how great I am.
So you push him forward. Now, what's your strength?
My strength is a 90.
Okay, what's your size?
Wow. Yeah.
My size is 75.
I said boulder. She's a
I'm strong massive.
One. Yeah.
Yeah.
Go ahead. What's your size?
75.
75. Okay. So you you see her. She kind of smiles a little bit as you're, you know, getting ready to push the sword forward. And it just fucking ticks you off.
Oh, did you and kill
you,
her?
You have this like surge and you push too hard and you push Leaf straight into her, oh. Right? Because his arm goes forward and you knock. Now Leaf is not as tall as you are or as strong. So you knock him forward and you catch her arm and cut into it. Do your damage for the sword.
God.
It's a 1d6.
Plus one, plus your damage bonus.
Wait, where? I've got, yeah, 1d6. Where's my damage bonus? Oh, God, it's another d6.
Yeah.
You're 1d6 plus
you're about
one.
To skewer
okay,
her like
six.
A leaf on the wind.
She's only half dead.
Six.
Okay.
Is the total.
All right. So you sever, like, a tendon right here. And all the blood starts coming out.
A tendon.
Yeah, just like right here, like right there. Just
oh, God.
And
that's a...
Ah! 6 points, that's probably her? Half of her...
This is her arm, right? Okay.
Yeah, that's probably half of her... she lets out this huge scream, and Leaf's mother comes out and goes, oh, my God, what happened?
Wow, Leaf, that was better than I expected. Gora, what were you doing? You should have gotten out of the way. You know
Leaf,
better than that.
Get in the house. You can't stab women like that. Get in the house. And Leaf kind of goes, and just kind of walks into
use
the
use that
home.
In battle.
And the mother
remorseless.
Goes, the mother comes, you know, goes over and says, are you okay? And starts, you know, helping her. And she goes, yeah, she's so, just the amount of pain, she can't really catch her breath. And, she kind of looks at you.
I'll work on your blocks next time if you want.
Horrible, horrible words are coming from her eyeballs. And, oh dear, come, we'll go see Ingo right now and we'll get your arm repaired and everything will be fine, it'll be all right. They leave for a moment and you're standing by yourself in this like kind of back area. That did not go the way you wanted it to go.
No.
So.
You barely got to hump Leaf at all. This is the worst.
So close.
Bad day.
So.
Already a bad day.
You are preparing. You're getting ready for this big battle that's coming up, right?
Yes.
You have to make sure you remember everything. You have to make sure that you talk about it several times in your head to make sure you get all the facts right. Get it all down on the old brain.
Yep.
Because there is no writing, and you don't have a chisel.
Nope.
So
no iPads.
No iPads. Which, speaking of chisel, iPads, and Bluetooth, I found out that Bluetooth...
Hold on. I want to see if I can guess where this is going.
The symbol for the Bluetooth is two runes put together, right? And it's after a Danish king... Harald Bluetooth, claimed, you know,
I can't take that guy seriously.
He said that that they are now
that's
Christian.
If anyone was not.
Yeah.
Headset Bluetooth.
Yes. So.
Where is Bluetooth?
Bluetooth. But that was just something.
Interesting.
Yeah, it was something I learned.
So Bragi is a member of our village.
He is. Ooh, yes.
Big fan.
Yes.
Big fan of yours.
Love your work. You know you'll be fighting in the battle as well, more than likely, but you're preparing...
Of course, I'm a man.
Yeah, you're preparing yourself for the fight. You hear something outside your back door. Like it's like you hear someone skulking around.
I am going to ignore it because I need to concentrate on my demonics. Yes, what is it? Hello?
Go away, please.
I knock the door open.
Bear!
Really?
Okay. Bear comes barreling in.
Wait, what?
Knocks you over. Or unless you can dodge. Give me a dodge. Thank you, BSB Care, for the one extra enemy.
BSB Care.
I'm gonna start calling him BSB Bear.
So this bear comes knocking.
He gave me pushes. It'll be fine.
And this isn't the same size of bear that attacked you.
Oh, good.
that makes it by one.
Wow. So you jump out of the way, and suddenly you've got this bear there.
Why wouldn't you?
Whoops.
Whoops.
Ha ha! Challenge!
Okay. Well, you want to swing?
Can I grab my spear?
Yeah.
This is my hut.
So give me a dex check to scramble to your spear without getting hit.
Okay. Spear is the right weapon to fight a bear with. That is not...
Okay, so he's going to get a chance to try to hit you.
You can push.
Can I push?
You can. Are we pushing? We said we're going to push in combat, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, I'm just remembering.
Woo. Much better. Made it by 35.
Oh, nice.
Okay, so what was that for? Getting your spear?
To scramble over and grab my spear.
Okay, so he swipes at you, but because you're dodging for your spear, you get your spear. Okay. You're doing your dex for your spear. Okay, so you have your spear, and this thing comes in, and it's smelling around, and you realize that you left a half-eaten goat's head somewhere in your...
I was eating this goat's head, and then halfway through, I would go distracted.
I had an idea.
So you realize that you've left a half-eaten goat's head somewhere in your house there. And the smell has become rancid.
First the hell beast bursts through the door. Yeah, the claws flashing. He's swooped out of the way.
Then he steals my goat's head.
Because you're talking too much.
No, I'm memorizing all of this. Okay. I'm memorizing all of this.
You ready? Oh, he hits you unless you can. Can I have that one? You can dodge again.
Okay.
We don't do that on Black Bag.
Yes. 22.
22, so you dodge. You're like, oh, I should remember this later and fight now.
Right.
So what do you want to do?
I will shout so that the village knows, and I will stab with the spear.
Hey, village! Yes. My goat's head's being stolen!
But wait! You have to change your dice.
Oh.
Now, I'm going to fuck this name up royally. I'm
going to
say
it's Bob, right?
It's Bob.
Just call him Mark.
Yeah. Wait, he took it away! Oh, now it's back. Okay, so... Quachulatas?
I think I have another set here.
Oh. Quachulatas. Oh.
There's some over here.
Or Quachulas? It's Q-U-A.
Coachella?
Coachella?
Nope.
Q-U-A.
It's Q-U-A-C-H-I-L-U-T-T-A-S.
Oh, Catacottle. No, I'm just kidding. I don't know what it was.
Good. I would have believed you.
Q-U-A-C-H-I.
L-U-T-T-A-U-S.
So, okay, Q-U-A-T-C-H.
You want mine? Here.
No. Quachulutas. Quick.
Quachulutas.
Quachulutas.
Zero. So, thank you very much. I'm sorry I messed your name up.
Call him Quachi, for short.
Quachi.
Oh, Quachi.
We call him the Quach.
What? In comes the Quach.
See, yeah,
now
cool
he'll
nickname.
They'll never donate again.
You can use that for free.
I've used my nicknaming powers
if
for evil
like
one too many times.
If you don't like what the players are calling you, you can buy me rerolls.
All right.
So.
All right. So
thank you very
nine.
Much for the new dice. Go ahead.
Yes, I made it by 9.
Okay, so you made it by 9.
102.9, the Quach.
Go ahead, give me dice. Give me a damage roll. Wow, who knew 3 pounds of sugar would get you so high?
Who knew?
Who knew?
It's never happened.
Oh, did you? Is it only
It's plus your half your damage bonus.
Just half my damage bonus?
Okay. With a spear.
Okay. So I guess we're going to call one a zero, and so four?
Well, I would just do 1, 2, and then 1, 2.
Okay, so 1 point, so okay. five points.
5 points. You stab this thing. Now, you're walking down the street with Inga. You see Leaf's mother coming with Gora. Gora?
Gora or something? Yeah, we'll
and
get back to
that. She's obviously hurt badly, and you're passing by.
Hi.
What's your house again?
The house
what's
of Broggy?
Your name again?
Broggy.
Broggy's house, and you hear this, like, it sounds like this horrible roar come from his house that, you know, isn't natural, like something in pain is just, you know, screaming out.
And you hear Broggy laughing.
Yes.
Ha 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 ha!
So either there's a bear in his house.
Yeah.
Or some really unnatural other thing is happening. You're not sure which.
It's either a groupie or a bear.
Or a groupie bear, which I mean could happen.
A D8. There's a. Oh, another D4?
Yeah, I need a D4 and a D8.
Inga, I think something might be going on in Broggy's house.
Oh, no, that's okay, because you're going to need those. I'm forced to use separate dice.
Yes. Well, okay. Should we go and look?
Yes, bring your giant sword.
I have a D4 okay. Here.
Or, well,
I found it.
Cool. All right.
Runk and sailor.
All set.
So, what do you do?
Go to Broggy's house.
Okay, which is literally right there.
Okay. Is the front, are we by the front door?
You're by the front door.
Okay, and it's closed?
It's closed.
Okay, so I'll knock on it. And be like, Broggy.
All right, so the bear swings at you.
Yes.
This is called juggling scenes. All right. Which I actually don't mind.
Think of some juggling scenes.
All right.
It's the same as heaven.
Jesus Christ. All right. Ouch, that was a four-sider. Ooh, he hits you unless you dodge. Not just so close.
Out, you hellish beast. I'm going to finish that goat's head later. But I honestly don't see a reason why not to try and push this.
All right. I don't see a reason why not either.
He wants to use up all your pushes before...
Yeah, that's fine.
The big battle comes.
Oh, no, your intestine is much worse.
Okay. So as you go up to knock on the door, Broggy hits through the door, hits you, and you guys go into the thoroughfare. Oh,
no.
Yikes.
Bear comes out.
All over again.
Bear!
Couldn't have you come to help me with my bear problem?
You know I haven't.
Okay, so you're laying on your back. You've got Broggy on top of you. Inga is only a half foot away.
Okay.
She's like, there's a bear where?
Come. We can take this bear.
I immediately play dead.
Okay. All right, so you just...
Grow.
Has anyone seen?
I'm sorry.
That's a new...
And I nothing.
Loud.
That's a new mic you just
Ting.
Did that to.
Hey, it's Groa.
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 Look up dog again.
Groa.
What? How do you say dog again? Was it Yivka? Yeah.
Bikya.
Bikya. Bikya. Okay, cool.
Krowa.
I have to remember that. That's going to become important
good.
Soon.
Yeah. I am playing dead.
All right.
But I do not soil myself.
Yes. We're not doing that.
Yes.
All right, you take 5 points of damage.
Ouch.
Oh, it's a four.
I do from Brody.
No, he does. You don't take any.
Oh. Yay.
Luckily, because you're so spineless, you just kind of go into whatever.
Like a jellyfish.
Like a jellyfish. You're fine.
Don't forget to call out.
5 points.
I got that.
Oh, yes. I'm sorry. Seven.
And Killian took 5 sand?
Yes.
Okay. I
was
going to
do the
up.
Same thing.
She realized what was going on.
I was
going
to do the same thing.
So does she not take extra sanity damage from making that realization? How
she
does that
usually,
work?
She doesn't take extra. She gets like a phobia or something, but because it was a cutscene, time is going to have passed when she joins you guys. So,
So we'll say it was like fear of going to the bathroom. Right. And we'll just imagine all the hilarity that happened in between now and then.
You'll feel, we'll do a one shot later and it'll be just animated. Talene. It's just Talene, it'll be animated. We'll do it live animated.
That's probably too much.
Nice.
I want the budget to do that, damn it.
Live animation? How far away are we from live animation?
Pretty far, I think.
We just film it and then we'll rotoscope it. It's,
We did complete the goal for this month.
Woohoo!
So everything else goes to live animation?
Yeah. $6 over.
Woo!
Oh, okay, cool. Awesome.
Okay, we're close.
Yeah.
100 million times close.
All right, so this bear is standing on your little, stoop. And you're on top of him.
Grimur.
Sorry.
And
it's a common mistake.
Inga is right next to you, and she has her sword. And she goes, "Where's the bear? In front of me or behind me?"
She's standing next to you.
She's like, "In front or behind?" And she's
right in front.
She swings.
Oh God!
Man, she's like.
I imagine her carrying like Cloud's sword from Final Fantasy VII. Like, his sword is
What is that?
Improbable llama.
That was totally outside. So we're good. Oh, she hits!
I have to call that one.
Wow,
she's got a really high sword. She swings her sword and smacks this thing right on the snail. Oh.
Were you even trying?
I know. Seriously.
4 points.
Wes is still drunk from 2 weeks
ago. Right?
He's still drunk.
Okay. So the amount of medication I'm on is making me a little shaky. I can't keep my hands straight there. All right.
Who did this?
Wes did.
Yes.
I was going to, but she beat me to it.
Jerks! Rumble of jerks! I can't turn my back a second! You can't go to the bathroom during Black Bag. No, you didn't. Sorry, guys. We're just like starting over.
Yes, because the pro move is to just put them in a different order.
Yeah,
I'm not quite sure why everyone during this game has such a hard time with staying through the whole thing and not having to go to the bathroom.
This would be a great time for the rest of us to go to the bathroom.
Okay, so she hits this bear.
Well struck.
And she's like, "Get off your ass and help! You're on your ass, aren't you? You fell out of the door."
No, I had a withdrawal. I wanted to get Grimur back into the fight.
Is that Goathead? Do I smell Goathead?
Perhaps.
Get your ass up here, help.
Yes, of course.
Go ahead, fight.
Fight.
I'll pin it.
Broggy versus bear.
Ooh.
Make it by a lot.
39. Okay. The important thing is that the Goathead is rancid.
Mm-hmm.
And he's still gonna eat it. He's still like, "Don't take my goat head."
It's like
There's still good meat on that goat head.
It's like 6-day-old taco. It's still good.
That wasn't me.
Oh yeah, you hit him good.
All right.
Hit that.
I also think it's the pressure of knowing that I'm probably gonna throw it over, and you guys are gonna say, "Haha, you threw it over," so I throw it over anyway.
Just do it anyway.
Yeah.
7.
8, right? Because it wasn't it 1-2-1-2?
2, yeah.
Two. I was doing 1-1-2 is 1, and 3-4 is 2.
Oh, okay, that's fine. That works.
That also works.
Yeah.
Yes.
Nick.
All right.
I'm sorry, yeah.
Ixnay.
Right, I mean, oh, yeah.
Rabble.
Because we believe in authentic frontier gibberish here.
Rabble. Please, come out to the audience.
Oh.
Bye,
guys. No, it's gone. Give it up for loss.
Don't even.
All right. I did do the new dice thing if you want to get rid of that one, Dom.
Five days away from me killing you.
Yeah, I did do the new dice thing.
I have been forced to use these garbage dice from the chest.
All right.
With which you are murdering a bear.
Yeah.
You hit it good.
These are my Deadlands dice.
And it starts to back up.
That horse riding by should stop and help with this fight.
Right,
and,
what a jerk. It starts to back up pretty quick, and it's running. It's not going to stick around to get hit by you two again. Do you let it go, or do you run
after it?
All right. Wait. So you're running through your house.
After I finish that half goat head, I'm hungry for half a bear.
Half a bear?
Son, are you okay? You feel a sore tip on your shoulder.
Is the bear
gone? Are you down there?
Please don't. I have... very weak skin.
Okay.
It might fall apart.
Come, come!
Shatter into pieces.
The bear's getting away!
Oh, no.
You can have it. yes, it's gone. You can get up.
Oh, good.
Just, you know, all right, get up. All right.
Watch out for the horse.
Do you have a problem with fainting a lot? Is that... You should try to...
No,
whenever you faint, you should... Or if you faint, you should tell someone you're talking to a god.
No, when I... That's actually a really good idea. I'm going to write that down in my brain.
Okay.
Write that down
It's just brain. A good way to avoid the whole you're a coward thing. So you're running after this bear. It bolts out the back. And
yes.
Starts running for this hole in the fence.
A man's life is pre-measured.
So, do you want to throw the spear, or do you want to try to catch it and shove spear in the back of the head?
I know a bear. It's a bear really, running is really
yeah,
fast. I'm not going to be able to.
Yeah, it's hurt too, so it's like panicking.
I'll try it. I'll try
Go
to throw
for
the,
it.
Throw the spear. Broggy rears back. Throw a spear. That's a two.
A two.
That's a good throw.
Wow.
You rolled a two?
I rolled a two.
Tell me what happens.
That's a critical success.
Go for it.
The spear flies through the air and catches the bear right behind the back. Arcs up and down right into the path of the bear. And the bear does the thing where like the front legs crumple and he slides forward
and is like right into the fence.
Yeah.
Okay.
Does it neatly sever his head for easy snacking on the go?
Snack head.
Yes, exactly. It's snack head. Snack bear. Pop top for ease of use.
Okay. So yeah, you walk over and you know.
This was not my day to die, bear.
Nature. So
just like a nun.
So I'll lift up the bear head.
So I'm gonna mess this name up. But for you get back one sand from
Yes!
Bob? Is that right?
Bob
right?
Bob.
Close. Thank
it's
you, Bob.
Biab.
Thank you for having an easy name that I can say.
Yes.
Thank you, Bob, for the one sand.
That one sand was the one I needed the most.
Yay. Yay.
Woohoo.
So you're kind of walk out of the bag.
How does healing work in this game?
Not well.
It doesn't happen.
I didn't think so.
Very rarely.
Yeah.
Healing happens if the gods really like you.
Ah, I gotcha.
Yikes.
Okay.
Pretty much.
So you're kind of walking slowly and whistling as you kick a rock and walk out so that no one, you know, sees you and you're a little embarrassed by that.
You're gonna look so nonchalant today.
You're not always nonchalant.
You see someone on the shore, kind of stumbling along the shore.
Anybody I recognize?
No, they're dressed in clothes that you haven't seen before.
The clothes?
Yeah.
Like the style?
Yeah.
Is it a man or a woman?
It's a woman. And she seems disheveled.
It's you, Tilly.
Hey there.
Super hot. She's
you
super hot. Add that she's super hot.
She's super hot.
I'm adventurous.
She's the hottest disheveled nun you've ever seen.
Yeah.
Do you look just like
disheveled old nun?
I do. The curly red hair, the green eyes,
she's
the Irish. Super hot.
Red hair.
Like she could land like early 90s Val Kilmer.
Ugh. Like twice.
Either early 90s or 1870s Doc Holliday Val Kilmer.
Yeah.
She could do that,
They
too.
Shot that movie not in the 1870s, though,
Wes.
You know that, right?
But I'm just saying, I thought they
Wait,
did.
What?
What?
Yeah, guys.
I thought that was the first Nickelodeon. Am I wrong?
Really?
No.
They did, and the 1820s Vikings were providing lot security.
Yes.
And crafty.
Yes.
That's when the
head.
Horns came
Have
in.
A rancid goat head.
That's when the
bear fat. Bear fat.
After bear half a day, they were all fired because they only served
the crafts table back then were real shit. I mean, they were terrible. M&Ms and bear fat.
I mean, like, the first person there got the eyeballs, and they were like, woohoo! But after that, there was just nothing good.
Damn your eyes. All too chewy. Late. All right, so, yeah, she's...
Three-day cheek.
She looks like she's been out in the...
Have I been in the elements? Because I'm fair. Yeah. I've got fair Irish skin. That doesn't hold up well.
She doesn't look well.
You there! What
language is she speaking?
Old Norris.
Old Norris.
Mm-hmm. We're going to have fun with this.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's exactly what
it sounds like. Here, she'll speak and I'll translate what you hear. Oh, good. Please continue.
I don't know if I want to.
No, it's fine. It's historically accurate.
Do you need help?
Flurby-dur-dur.
That's what I hear is flurby-dur-dur.
Yep.
I cannot understand how Vikings can be scary if they talk like that.
Don't.
It's usually the sword that makes them scary.
Yeah.
Flurby-dur-dur.
Flurby-dur-dur.
It's when they're stabbing you.
Stabby, stab, stab. Dummy, dumb, dumb.
In reality, I do probably know some Old Norse because the Vikings
raided
frequently, but they also
would. You know how to say I swallowed it, motherfuckers.
They would also. Yeah, that's true. I totally know those words. But they would also, like, they would, after a successful raid, they would, like, hunker down for a few months usually, and then some people would stay as a settlement.
Mm-hmm.
According to the TV show, at least as far as I know. Anyway, yes.
Go ahead.
So I probably know some Old Norse, but...
Well, here, then I'll throw in the
broken,
outward.
Probably like...
But very, very, very weak. Broken. So if she says, so if you say something like...
What'd you say?
I don't remember what I said now, you've ruined it.
Floor, floor, floor.
Which way is the bathroom?
Like,
I think she said, where did you come from?
Where did you come from?
Where did flurp der?
I think she just said, you there.
You there?
Like, I would get that.
Well, my computer's making a lot of weird noises all of a sudden. Woo-hoo!
Yeah, you design audio. That's,
That's all we can do.
It should make weird noises.
Yeah, it's not making a good noise. Or is that I hope that's the refrigerator.
I think that's the refrigerator.
I hope so.
Yeah, the
refrigerator. I'm like, holy shit, my computer's dying.
I hear the fridge right now.
Okay, that's the refrigerator. Okay, so, that was weird. All right.
Is your computer going,
that's Jordan.
That's me.
All right, so.
Holy no, though.
Just so we can keep the story going.
So,
go ahead.
Question, so do I have any kind of anything?
No, you don't.
Do I even have my...
You have your rosary?
My rosary and my prayer book?
Which you also swallowed. Yeah. Your book. Wait,
the prayer book and the rosary?
I'm going to let you decide how you got the rosary back. It's your choice.
In that nobody wants
one. Prayer book's got to be, like, completely sodden, though, right?
Yeah, it's pretty...
It's parchment.
It'll come back at some point.
Parchment loves water.
All right, so we're good. All right.
But I'm like, staggering along a beach.
Yes. You don't remember anything.
I don't remember anything.
Except for throwing up in Gilgai.
That's the last thing I remember.
Do you want to translate for her Gaelic?
Oh, yes. Hold on a minute. I got to get some in my head here.
You ready?
Water.
Murph.
We're like,
Gaelic is way cooler than that.
At least it's not Welsh. She'd still be saying water right now.
That's true.
I'll just get a little closer to her, but...
I'm going to back away. She looks like a Viking.
She totally
looks.
She speaks like a Viking.
I'm huge.
She actually looks bigger than most Vikings you've seen.
Carrying a sword?
Yeah, always.
I'm going to run away.
Okay.
I will chase you if you run away.
Yeah, okay.
Wow. Okay.
Well, I'm assuming she's a spy at this point.
Okay.
Really? That was a big thing back then? I don't think so.
We just dealt with some spies.
So she's not very fast. You're kind of fucked up. And so she catches you easily.
Uh-huh.
And grabs you, kicking and screaming.
I'm going to start praying.
She starts saying all these words. In Latin that you've never heard before.
Yep.
In nomine Patris.
Yep, go ahead.
Spiritus Sancti.
Nope, that's not it.
Godfather.
No. Yeah, I don't know.
Guys, Dom is smoking over there.
What is happening?
It's weird.
At my age of 17, very old, 17, I might have gone on like a few raids at this point, so I would probably at least, I might realize that she's from, I mean, somewhere else. Like once I got closer.
Oh yeah, would, yeah, definitely, definitely. You'd recognize that she wasn't one of your people.
Right. So I'm gonna take her to the Jarl.
Over your shoulder?
Sure. Okay. It'd be much easier and faster that way, probably.
Yeah. Praying the whole way. Okay. Just praying.
Murph.
Yeah.
You know, it's in Latin.
Yeah, these were really, really fearful people. I don't know.
It all kind of sounds the same now. Every language.
It all kind of goes together.
I mean, we're all just one people,
aren't we? 800.
This would be a good time. Zenir Faith, does your prophecy... So, give me a roll.
Did my pro ever happen? Did I miss it?
Not yet.
Not yet?
Not yet. I'm holding that for...
A real combat?
Not a bear combat. Not where you're trying to, like, one-up your...
And I did. Oh, I did.
Oh, shit.
What'd you do?
Wow.
Oh, is it a good prophecy or a bad prophecy?
What does 20 get you again?
20 is a life or death situation.
Okay, cool.
Ooh.
You get a... as you're, you know, getting up off the ground from the sudden bear.
happens a lot.
Bear. You start standing up and you feel that whooshy feeling in your brain.
Seldon's there, he knows. Seldon.
He goes right back down.
And you see what looks to be like you pushing your father out of the way right as he's about to be attacked by the albino. And you push him out of the way and you guys kind of tumble down and you save his life.
Okay.
That's the vision that you have.
Okay.
You now have a feeling of exactly when you're supposed to do that.
Okay.
So I would say that's a pro.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
So thank you for doing that, by the way. That was from Zenir.
Zenar
Faith.
Thank you, Zenar
Faith.
I'm terrible. Fucking horrible. All right. So you have this vision. And, you know, the mom, Leaf's mom, and the girl come up, and she's cut. It's like, I need healing, you know. I need this to be bandaged up before the battle so I can fight. And her muscle has been, like, just cut.
Oh.
And so, like, it's kind of sliding up a little bit over here a little.
She's a strong warrior.
And it looks pretty bad. She might lose it. It is 827 CE. So, you know, medical science isn't really all that far ahead.
Yeah.
So, like, that bitch, oh, I can't believe she did it. She cut me. Oh, my son was holding the sword. She didn't mean it. She's just overly excitable and a little too large.
Everyone in the village thinks so.
Inga, someone is hurt. We should
Let
help.
Me see it. Where is it?
Well, you can't. I'll describe it to you.
Don't use your sword.
Just give. What's broken? Put it. What's hurt?
Her arm muscle appears to have been.
Come here, child. And the, you know, she goes over. Groa. She comes over and she, you know, just grabs her arm. Ah! Oh, yeah, that looks like it's painful.
Jeez!
How'd this happen? Well, I was trying to help out Leaf learn how to fight, and he was thrusting. We were teaching him how to thrust really hard forward. He needs to, this is something all young men need to know how to thrust.
All young men.
And he hit me, and Ingo stops for a second. She goes, wait a minute, you stood in front of a young man with a large sword? Well, I was just trying to help him. That's not a good idea. You don't stand in front of a man with an unsheathed sword when he's about to thrust. You don't do that.
I'm gonna...
A sheathed one. It needs to be sheathed.
It needs to be at least sheathed.
We've been working on that one all night.
No. But...
Wear a sheath.
Wear a sheath.
I'm gonna start...
Don't come in. Thrusting.
Is there anything around with which we could, like... I don't know. I want to try and address... While they're talking about the merits of, you know, pro-sheath, anti-sheath, I want to, like, try and address her arm in some way.
Address it?
Farquaad gives you 2 points back.
Oh, thank you, Farquaad.
Hey, arm.
And we did the prophecy. Okay. So go ahead. Sorry.
I want to try and, do what I can for her.
Do you have first aid?
I have medicine but I just have basic first aid.
Okay, give me a roll.
72.
I do not make that roll.
Push it.
It's just grow up.
Grow up.
Do you want to push it or no?
I guess.
I thought that just grow up means I'm going to push it. I don't know.
Okay, I'll push it.
I'm a sadist.
I'll push it, although this is not a good idea.
Yeah.
This is a bad idea. Yeah, that was a bad idea. I think if I can maybe manually reattach this with my finger.
So you grab the tendon and you pull.
I see what's happening here. And if I just pull
and
it
pulls out a little bit and kind of snaps even worse.
Whoops.
And you hear a tearing sound.
A tearing sound?
And like part of the muscle kind of flops off to the side, right? And she screams. And she's like, ah!
Inga.
And Inga's like, daft boy! And smacks you in the shoulder. Says, don't do that. You don't pull on the tendon. You massage it a little bit before you pull on it. Now I need 3 pigs. Let's go back to my hut. Come on, we'll get her taken care of. I'm sorry, honey. I think you're going to lose the arm. All right, so they start to walk off, right? You guys walk off.
Okay.
You've got this bear.
I'm butchering this bear, and I'm
you're like just dis in the back with your spear. Like, how are you butchering this bear? I don't know why you're not smart. You said I just
figured. Well, okay, I'm not that dumb.
Okay,
you just skin it with a spear. It always takes me so long.
Roll for intelligence. I'm kidding. It's a joke.
I'm a little slow. I'm not completely stupid.
You're not stop sign slow.
Yes.
Okay. Good.
Bragi is carving up this bear, saving the skin, and composing the Edda that he's going to regale everyone with about how he killed this bear.
Okay. So
he's probably singing a little bit to himself, and you know can kind of be heard as he's chopping into it. He's probably doing a pretty lousy job,
right,
butchering this bear, but.
All right.
But he's happy.
Okay. So much awesome is going on. I thought we'd be. It's good. So you're chopping up this bear good.
Of course you are.
And you know, you hear mur, 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 all the way down the street, all the way coming up. Mur, mur.
Murph.
Murph. Murph. Murph. Murph. Murph.
Is this supposed to be me?
Murph.
I'm not saying that. I have found a Latin prayer that I'm going to chant for you.
Murphitus.
Murphitus.
Murphitus. Murph. 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 Murphitus. Are you ready?
Yeah,
no, this is background.
Okay,
you gotta be doing other stuff. I'm gonna do it softly in the background.
We have to be doing other stuff.
Oh, we're doing other things.
Yeah, because this is just what I'm just mumbling.
Just the village woodcutter cutting
wood. Largely led the beast just through the wall,
to stab
but mighty Bragi dodged its claws.
I will.
Of thunder.
I will say that I feel like chat needs to hear you say this a little bit.
All right.
I'm doing laundry nearby.
Okay, Sancte Michele Arcangelo, defende nos in praelio contra nequitiam et insidious diabole est presidium, imperate ille Deus supplices deprecarum, toque principes milite celestis, Satanum, aliosec, spiritus malignos, quiat perdit.
So she's speaking all of this, you know, whispering this to herself as she's praying, as you're carrying her up. And you kind of look over and you see him.
Biruna, what do you have there?
I found her down by the water. I figured I'd take her to the Jarl just in case.
Ah, good idea. I have a bear.
Good. Did you kill him yourself?
Yes, I did. Would you like to hear the story?
Oh, I will. Let me take her to the Jarl first, but later tonight.
Ha ha, yes.
Excited to hear it.
Okay, so you go to the Jarl. All right. And the Jarl is looking at this, you know, at this, like, pile of bones that are spread out very intently. And you walk through the door, and he looks up at you and goes, "Who's that?"
I found her wandering down by the water, and when I got close, she started to run away. And
she looks like she's had a horrible fright there. She looks very, very sick. Or, is she okay? Bring her over here.
I don't know. I just, since we are about
ready. He pushes all the bones off the table, all of his chicken bones and whatnot. I don't know how Inga reads these damn things. I've been staring at them for hours, and they don't make any sense to me.
Me neither. I'll just kind of
flirpity flirp.
Wait, so flirpity flirp flirp. And what I see is a table loaded up with chicken bones that they slide off to put me on it as though to eat me.
Yeah.
I have to lose my shit right now.
Okay. Give me a sand check. That was, it's a good time for a sand check.
Nerf. 36.
You're so sane.
All right, so fine.
You care not.
You care not.
Whatever.
I care not.
They lie down.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not.
I don't know what.
And
maketh me to pass through green pastures. Something, something. I used to know Bible verses.
Jesus
wept.
That's okay. At least it's fair. When the first game I played with Amy, and she was a Bible salesperson, she picked this app that didn't have actual Bible verses. They were like just inspirational sayings. So she would go from actual Bible verses to, you know, be the best person you can be in God's light. Like something you would never read in the Bible, right?
Right. It was As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall not fear.
Because these Bibles are on sale for only $14.95.
Right.
Value.
So
saith the Lord.
You're laid down and you're praying, right? And
yeah.
And she's on one side.
Dear God.
What?
What? Dom wants a cookie, guys. Hold on.
You had three cookies, young man.
Time out on Call of Cthulhu, because Dom wants a cookie.
No, don't you we
Dom.
Take all the rest.
Chat knows.
Yeah. Take those cookies.
Take them out.
We don't let him have anything
rice
else.
Or beans, Dom.
Rice or beans.
You can't have both.
Or beans.
You get all of them.
Whoops.
Yeah, please take them.
Nice executive decision you guys made for the table.
That's right.
It was for more for us than you.
Gotta have another cookie.
Look at how I kept one for me when I did it, too.
Yeah. Real cool.
Dick move. All right, so.
I don't like these guest players. No. I don't want it.
Fine.
God.
So, Ned's gonna hold his breath.
They lie you down, and you're on the table that used to have the bones on it. And Orin the Blood Drinker comes over.
Oh, dear God. Do I hear that's his name? Do I understand that's his name?
No.
He's the Jarl.
He puts his hand on your forehead. And
big, scary, bearded man, though, right?
And kind of looks down at you, and you are insanely hot nun. And he has no idea what a nun is. And he goes, "Oh, child, you're so you're so beautiful." And he starts petting your head in a very uncomfortable way. He says, "I'll take care of her. You get ready for the battle."
Fluff, fluff, fluff.
And he just
fluff, fluff. I'm just saying, fluff, fluff.
No.
He's just kind of petting your hair and like just looking at you like you're the most beautiful person ever and talking to you.
Jarl,
whatever that is.
If I may.
Yes?
This strange woman appeared on our beach.
She's not a threat. Look at her. She's beautiful. She has all her teeth. How can she be? She's not a spy.
But I don't feel comfortable leaving her with you alone. Maybe.
I can tell. I didn't get Blood Drinker by not drinking blood. I can be fine.
All right, but if you need help, I will be preparing for battle, but
besides, I haven't been married in a long time.
I'm looking around for something sharp and pointy.
I'm sure that, you know, I mean, if we can teach her our language instead of saying Murph all the time.
Murph.
Maybe she would make a good stepmother.
I mean, it is your prerogative, Carl.
I'll be fine, trust me.
I want to find something sharp and pointy and attack.
So you're looking around desperately.
Yeah.
She just wants us to stop, actually.
You guys, this is just like watching Vikings.
You don't even watch it.
I know, but it's just like watching Vikings. You just listen to it in
the background. But not.
Applestan.
All right. So he's looking at you, and you realize he's got a knife.
I figure out of the things that you guys said, I caught the words blood.
Okay.
Which was said several times.
Why don't you roll, do you have, what's your language right now? Do you have
my language is Gaelic.
At all or no?
Your other language is Latin though, right?
My other language is Latin.
So roll against idea. And
okay.
Make it, it's going to be a hard roll, so it's going to be half your intelligence.
Half my intelligence.
Yes.
That's
a hard roll.
Yeah. Nope, too smart for this.
Do you want to push it?
Push it.
Do you agree?
Push. Sounded a little
nasty, doesn't it?
Gross.
Yeah.
Oh. Sorry.
Doop 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 doop. Flippy doop.
Was that half? 36.
No. 30. Yes.
All right.
30. 75 minus. Nope. Everything I'm saying is wrong.
No. It's half.
Yeah.
It's half.
Yeah.
So you recognize these phrases?
Yeah, barely.
You recognize these phrases? Blood drinker.
Blood drinker.
Marriage.
Oh.
She'll be fine with me. That's what you hear.
I don't believe any of this.
Okay.